Hi everybody, today is April 10th, 2013. South Korea asks Russia, China to rein in North Korea. The South Korean government has asked Russia and China to help restrain North Korea from making military provocations as tensions increase on the Korean Peninsula over an expected intermediate-range missile launch by Pyongyang, its foreign ministry said on Wednesday. Through close coordination with China and Russia, the Korean government has been continuing to make efforts to persuade North Korea to change its attitude, Yonhap News Agency quoted South Korean Foreign Ministry Yum Byung-si as saying at a parliamentary committee meeting. Yum confirmed Pyongyang has moved an intermediate-range Musudan ballistic missile to its east coast and is prepared to launch the missile at any time from now. According to intelligence obtained by our side and the U.S., the possibility of a missile launch by North Korea is very high. Young said the missile, which has a range of 3,500 kilometers or 2,200 miles, could hit the U.S. territory of Guam, Young said. A high-level coordination channel with the U.S. is now fully operational to cope with any provocations from North Korea, Young said. U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry is expected to arrive in South Korea on Friday for talks with the South Korean Foreign Ministry. Well, we'll just have to wait and see. Now, that would be today, our time, the 10th. South Korea is 14 hours ahead of us. So we would know today, later this afternoon or tonight, if John Kerry, in fact, did go. U.S. officials said on Monday they have asked Russia and China for help in getting Pyongyang to back off from its increasingly threatening rhetoric and inflammatory actions, which have alarmed its neighbors and prompt the Pentagon to heighten its military readiness. Russia has said what's going to happen is Kim Jong-un is going to paint himself into a corner with all these threats. Just to save face, he's going to have to follow through. And all the international community said, this time, that's it. We're not going to give in to their threats. They're not going to give them what they want. They're not bending over anymore. It worked in the past for the father and the grandfather, so I guess Kim thinks that these threats will work for him. But they've had enough. Enough is enough. Nope. We have asked China and Russia to use their influence with North Korea to get them to cease this provocative behavior, White House Press Secretary Jay Carney said at a press briefing on Monday. Russian President Vladimir Putin appealed for calm on the North Korean Peninsula on Monday at a joint news conference with German Chancellor Angela Merkel in Hanover, Germany. I would like to call on everybody to calm down and sit down at the negotiating table and calmly resolve the issues that had been accumulating there for many years, Putin said. Putin warned the escalating tensions in the region could lead to a nuclear disaster far worse than Chernobyl's accident in 1986. What he actually said was that the accident in Chernobyl would look like a fairy tale compared to what's coming. They're saying that the Chernobyl accident was the world's worst nuclear accident, Russian Foreign Ministry Sergei Lavrov said on Tuesday. Moscow will push to normalize the situation on the Korean Peninsula. North Korea announced on Monday it was suspending operations at the Kaesong Industrial Complex that it runs jointly with South Korea and employs more than 53,000 North Korean workers. There's about 450, 445 managers that are South Korean that were still there. And I showed you last night images of cars and trucks loaded sky high coming across the border from the north into the south. Possibly some of these managers, I don't know, but they looked a little rushed to get across the border. Pyongyang advised foreign embassies to consider pulling staff out of Pyongyang by Wednesday, after which it said it cannot guarantee the safety of diplomats in the capital. In the first video that I posted showing these cars and trucks crossing the border, there was one car with diplomatic flags. Couldn't tell what country, just that the flags were red. The U.S. announced over the weekend it had delayed an intercontinental ballistic missile test in order to avoid further escalation of the conflict, a move that won praise from Putin on Monday. Tensions have been rising since December, when international sanctions against North Korea were imposed in response to a long-range rocket launch, which it claimed was a satellite launch and the UN said was a trial of ballistic missile technology. Pyongyang responded with a nuclear test in February, which was met by more sanctions approved by the United Nations Security Council. Now, North Korea has threatened a preemptive nuclear strike against the U.S. mainland and U.S. military bases in the region. Many analysts think Pyongyang's actions are more related to the new leader's Kim Jong-un need to prove his credentials with his own military hardliners and extract concessions from the international community rather than any real desire for a conflict with foreign powers. But this time the blackmail is not going to work. The foreign powers are not going to bend over and give him what he wants. And like what Sergei Lavrov said, he's painting himself into a corner. Kim Jong-un has no military experience. He went to school in Switzerland, okay? All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe. Always be prepared for a disaster, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.